who want to hear from our big man. Notice I say our big man because I'm the president of the Big Man Alliance. When there's another down the big man that does what I've done, I will move out of the way. But other than that, I'm not leaving this chair. So, you know, I've always said 28 and 10 is the formula for big guys to be dominant. Of course, when you go to the playoffs, you got to add to your PPG and your RPG. But, hey, I'll take 42 and 10 anytime. So, Mr. Embiid, keep it up.
Keep it up all he want to. Kevin Durant is the MVP right now, Shaquille O'Neal. The brother's averaging 30 on 54% shooting, better than 40% from three-point range. And, oh, by the way, 18-month hiatus because of an Achilles tear. He's the MVP right now.
And I saw what you said yesterday, and I agree with everything you said yesterday. The man had 18 months off, and he came back like he has a Mr. B. Yes, Kevin Durant, Durantula, is also my MVP. I have to go with Stephen A. on this one, Max.
Shaq, we're acting like there's no defensive side of the ball. Not that KD can't play defense, but have you seen Embiid this year?
Defense is overrated, Max. Max, defense is overrated. Stop it.
Shaq, Embiid is the closest thing the league has right now to you. And because the league is not as big man oriented anymore, everyone thinks it's a disadvantage. He's abusing these little dudes.
Say it again. He's the closest thing to what?
To you in the league right now,
Static. I can't hear you, Max. It's a lot of static. It's a lot of static in my microphone. I cannot hear you.
Shaq, but for real, you had Penny, and Penny was great, but Penny wasn't a guard version of Shaq. Kobe was. Dwayne Wade was like Shaq great as a guard, and that's what it takes for a big to win championships. He needs another dude as good as him. Can Simmons be that guy for Embiid, do you think?
I think Simmons can be that guy. I think, you know, Ben just needs to focus on this game. You know, a lot of people shoot the three, do this and do that, but I think he's averaging 18, 19 points, you know, just doing his way. You know, definition of a great player is making the ones around you better. So I think he just needs to stay aggressive, get to the hole. Once the defense collapses, just kick it out to you guys and, you know, hopefully, you know, the others can, you know, step up. But every now and then he's going to have to, you know, pull out that mid-range shot and occasionally hit a three. So I think if he can do that, they should go pretty far.
You got four championships on your resume. Three came with the Los Angeles Lakers. Right now, they're the prohibitive favorites. Do you think, A, they deserve to be the favorites in light of what we've seen assembled in Brooklyn? And B, do you see anybody out west challenging the Lakers this season?
I think they do deserve to be the favorites because they're the champs. You have to knock off the champs. Anybody in the West, Denver, look, it's a lot of competitive teams out there. Let me finish. It's a lot of competitive teams out there, but I don't think it's a team that can beat them in a seven-game series. A lot of teams.
What about the Clippers? What about Kawhi?
Bro, we said that last year. So, you know, until the Clippers beat them, you know, it's just still the same old talk. And I get tired of watching you talk the same old talk. That's why I like – that's like when you talk, I put it on mute. I love hearing Molly and Max talk because they speak real facts, unlike you. You just be – I put it on mute. And then when the intelligent, smooth brother of Max Kellerman –
Okay. You know what's coming because I'm watching you on TNT. You know what's coming. I'm going to get you for that. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to get you. Watch. You know him.
Well, as usual, Shaq has a lot of very smart things to say.
Please, he's being too kind.
Shaq, lying. When I look out west, there are two teams that are interesting to me this year that maybe aren't getting as much press as some of the others, Dallas and Phoenix. What are your thoughts about their chances this year, Dallas and Phoenix?
Very young. They should go pretty far in the playoffs, but I don't think they have enough to beat the Lakers. You know, the team that scares me, if they're on full throttle, no mistakes, everybody's healthy, I'm always scared of Portland. CJ and Dame, I think they're the best backcourt in basketball right now, those two, especially when they go going and they're shooting at a high rate. Clippers also scare me, but look, I need everybody to play at a high level. I want to see that Indiana Pacers Paul George, the aggressive Paul George going through the hole, dunking, stepping out, shooting threes. I don't like seeing Paul when he goes up and down. I want to see the Indiana Pacers Paul. And Paul's been playing great, so I'm not going to jump on my guy Paul. But, you know, if Paul could play at a high level with Kawhi playing at a high level, then, yes, they can challenge the Lakers.
Shaq, talk to me about Novex Biotech. What's the deal?
Well, I wanted to be sexy like your husband. So, You know, I was filling with fuzzies.
How was your inspiration?
I tried everything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, listen, your husband is beautiful. He's sexy. I know he has a six pack. I said, you know what? I'm looking like Charles Barkley now. My belly is hanging over my belt line. So when I tried Novak GF9, I got more active. I was sleeping through the night, and I have energy. And yes, Stephen A. Smith, I have a six pack. I'll send you a text right now. I'll send you a text right now, Stephen A. Smith.
I'll deal with you later.
Say I
won't. I'm not going to say what I want to say. You know damn
right
well
now.
You don't have no six pack.
See? Okay. Here's my phone.
Oh, Lord.
You haven't tried Novak's biotech, Stephen A.
Unless he lost about 30 pounds in 2 days.
I did.
When Shaq started taking Novak's biotech, he was 6'1".
I got it.
Check your phone.
He did send it to
me. I don't even want to see it.
This is ridiculous.
All right, President of the Big Man Alliance.
What did he send you? Let's see it.
No, yeah, I ain't showing it.
Show
it.
Go ahead, show it. Go ahead, show it.
Y'all can't see this.
Is that a bathroom selfie?
He's sitting there with a six. He's trying to say it's a six pack. He just sent it to me.
That's not him. Get out of here.
What you mean? That's Bali. That's me.
He took this a year ago. He took this a year or two ago.
When did he take that? When you were in the finals? He saved it in his library.
He just sent it to me. I ain't buying that. I know what I saw.
Shaq, I want to see the date on that photo. That was in the archive. Oh, my goodness. All right. Shaq, I'm told you got to go. Always a good time. I knew you'd bring me a smile and a laugh. Stay safe. We'll talk to you soon.
Lose some damn weight.
Shaq, he can do what he wants.
You see the picture?
It's two years old.
Look at it.
It's two years old. Look at that background. Please.
Shaq, you got to hold the newspaper up.
That ain't got nothing to do with the six-pack. That ain't got nothing to do with it.
Oh, my God. Goodbye. Bye, everyone. What's up with the Nets? The big three fall to the Cavs. Got questions? Well, who's more valuable to their team? Is it Patrick, or would you say Josh Allen?
Patrick Mahomes. And I think it's easily Patrick Mahomes. Respect to Josh Allen, who's been superb most of the season. He had a little hiccup, maybe a third of the way into the season, but otherwise has been superb, and including in the playoffs, has led his teams to wins. Mm-hmm. But right now, who's playing better defense, the Chiefs or the Bills? Like, can you imagine the Bills surviving a bad game from Josh Allen? Because I can. Can you imagine the Chiefs surviving a bad game from Patrick Mahomes? No. And is it linked to his weapons? When you have Travis Kelce and Tyreek Hill, and when you have Andy Reid as the head coach, a quarterback whisperer like that, is that all tied to his success? Of course it is. But he's got to deliver the goods. Respect to Chad Henne and what he did at the end of that game and the play call of Andy Reid. Do any of us believe had Chad Henne started that game, they would have won? I don't. You think they would have won with Chad Henne against Cleveland? I don't. And I don't think they would win against Buffalo. But the way Buffalo's been playing defense, look what they just did to the Ravens, run game. The way they're playing defense, Josh Allen could have a nice, solid game and they could win. We all know the Chiefs can't have a nice, solid game from Patrick Mahomes. They need him to be Superman.
I believe you're wrong. I believe you're wrong, however, because philosophically, you and I have never been on the same page with this matter. Like, for example, you know, years ago when CP3 got injured, and you felt like that cost Houston the trip to the finals. I felt like Golden State, KD, Steph, Clay, they would have found a way no matter what. It's similar here. I'm thinking Kansas City would have found a way with Tyreek Hill, with Travis Kelce, with Williams in the backfield, with Le'Veon Bell, with the weapons that they have available, Mecole Hardman and others, with Andy Reid and Eric Bieniemy, they would have figured out a way. That's my belief. And so when I look at it from that perspective,